Universiade. 31 countries from across the world represented, from Australia to the Republic. The Universiade began as a concept back in 1923 with the International Universities Championships in Paris. The first Universiade as such came at Chamonix in 1960. Since then, it's taken place with regularity as students from across the world test their abilities against each other. Strbske Pleso hosted the 1987 edition and now stepping in to work with Granada on this 2015
edition.
Taking part in the athletes parade prior to the lighting of the flames. All of them with different musical tastes. Great cheers for the host country, Slovakia.
The game's opened
with three speakers. Juraj Draxler, the Slovakian Minister of Education and Sport,
after a period
giving an
of 16
address.
Years, promote Slovakia, but more specifically, dears, my
followed
dear friend,
of FISU,
it's a great honorsiade. You know, the Universiade is much more than a great sporting event.
Dear participants, sportsmen,
Martin Novoroni is successful medalist in Nordic combined at the 1999
and officially opening the game as the Slovak flag already raised, the FISU flag, the Universiade flag flying proudly alongside it, along with the flags of all 31 ex-Slovakian athletes, Lubomira Ilanovska doing her bit. The flame finally lit, the oaths taken by the athletes, representatives of the athletes and the coaches.
It was quite a short time to prepare all the necessary for the beginning and for the 27th Strbske Pleso.
All looking forward to these 10 days of competition in Slovakia before the party moves on to Granada in Spain. The Nordic competition is taking place in Slovakia, cross-country skiing, biathlon, Nordic combined and the ski jump.
Let the games begin.
The opening event of the Universiade Winter Games was the biathlon. This in Osrblie, the men's 20-kilometer individual. And the smart money was saying that this race was wide open. Russians and Ukrainians with strong teams. Air temperature, thankfully, had dropped to below zero. The area's been starved of snow. The snow you're about to see, artificial snow, pumped by snow cannons. Wind, very, very mild. This man, Ukrainian Dmytro Rusinov from Sumy State University, wearing the bib number 5, one of the early goers. And he was to make a very, very strong start and a good impression. 24 years young, and that's relatively old by these standards. Not a man who was to give him most problems. But the Russians, number 39, Vadim Filimonov, and number 40, Yuri Shupin. They went out just after each other. Clear advantage. Team tactics. Not really at play in the biathlon, but it doesn't hurt, does it, if you've got your teammates spurring you on. 20 kilometers for the uninitiated, that's five shots per round, four rounds, 20 shots in total, five laps, 4 kilometer each distance. Here was Filimonov. He went after Rusinov. Very undulating course here. Technically tough. That was the consensus amongst all the coaches. Russians, just like their Ukrainian neighbors, powerhouse in the biathlon. Talking of Ukrainians, this was Rusinov leading the way. He came up to the first split after 1.2 kilometers. Rusinov just to get his nose in front. Great shot of the shooting. Four rounds of shooting. Two prone, that's lying down, two standing up. They were alternated. Rusinov. This is his standing up. So hard to bring down your heart rate by about 20 beats per minute. And look at that fantastic sharp shooting. Rusinov setting the pace. At the end, Shubin just getting ahead.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the ceremony for individual 20-kilometer men.
Keep an eye on the clock. 50 minutes, 15.4 seconds. And that would prove good enough for second place and the silver medal. Rusinov, early shots. Stretching.
Medal ceremony.
Get as good a time as possible.
Rusinov, ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the FISU anthem.
In Strbske, Pleso, it's the first day of the cross-country events of this 27th Universiade. It's the sprints day, usually and traditionally a day of great excitement. The weather, good for the sprints actually, a little bit of snow, but the snow was holding firm and the prospects were of some quick racing. This was in the ladies' semi-finals, one big shock here when Sandra Shvetsova, the Czech skier, went down with just 100 metres or so to go before the finish. She gave up second place and a place in the final. The semi-final was won by Evelina Marcic. Coming through in second, Anastasia Slavona. Slavona was into the final. And no place at all for Sandra Shvetsova. This is the final in Trentino in 2013. It was a clean sweep of Russian women on the podium, but that not possible this time around. Six nations represented in this sixth final. The favourite, Evelina Marcic of Poland, she was quickest in the qualifying. Looked so comfortable, that's her wearing number one, looking so comfortable. Svetlana Nikolaeva, experienced Russian, also in the mix, as well as Slavona. Marianne Bouillet, the French woman, coming in. It's a tight finish. It's victory on the line for Anastasia Slavona of Kazakhstan. Great victory for the student from Kalmati. And Evelina Marcic picked up second place. And Nikolaeva picked up the men's final. Was perhaps a little more predictable in that the Russians dominated from start to finish. Great experience, Anton Gafarov, an Olympian, Raul Shakirzyanov, a multi-medalist of previous Universiades, Andrei Larkov, also in the mix. That's those three at the front, following the Maciej Starega of Poland, Aurelius Herberger of Austria, and Lucas Chanave of France. It was the Russians who dominated. Just coming towards into the last turn and heading for the line. It's going to be another tight one. Larkov wearing 14, Gafarov 2, Shakirzyanov wearing 9. Larkov, Andrei Larkov, who takes the gold. Anton Gafarov takes silver. And Raul Shakirzyanov completes a Russian clean sweep in the cross-country men's sprint. There's the win, collecting their flowers. Anastasia Slonova of Kazakhstan, Evelina Marcic and Svetlana Nikolaeva. First medals in the cross-country for them And what a happy day for the Russians, Andrei Larkov, Anton Gafarov, and Ural Shakir Zianov. Great performance from them, great performance from the Russians. Of course, plenty more cross country to come during this 27th Universiade. You'll be so spread your wings and
fly. Women's 15 kilometers individual was the second race on the opening day of the biathlon competition.
4 minutes to the start.
Temperature, as you can see, just under zero, minus 1.6 degrees centigrade. First of the hot favorites go as Ekaterina Avakumova from Russia. Russian men had won silver and bronze. Men's individual, 20k earlier in the day. Could she go one better? Next one, amongst the strong contenders, Paulina Fialkova. The Slovak Cup, wearing bib number 12. Slovak, with that trademark smooth style, soon showed she was a force to be reckoned with. Combination of smooth technique, gutsy determination, usually a winning combination. Should it prove so for her? Avakumova was the first of the strong favourites to start. Hers was the time to watch. Alina Rajkova, she went off in group two. Right at the end of it, considered a strong position. Nonetheless, she was putting in a very strong performance. If you're watching those those skis didn't cross at the back. Fast forward to Fialkova on the shooting range. All of the Slovak women showed great speed with their shooting. Sometimes at the cost of accuracy. That's a sacrifice. Fialkova, very, very fast away from the range. When it came to sharp shooting, nobody was sharper than this young woman, the Russian, Avakumova. The graphic doesn't lie. Three zeros mean no misses. That was to continue. In the final round, no misses at all for the Russian. Setting the pace. As you can see, Rajkova, she missed a single shot on her second round, the standing shooting. Well, that's not a finish. Fialkova, wearing bed number 12, is in the line. Quick look at the scoreboard before collapsing in a bundle. Ekaterina Avakumova, on steady pace. It didn't seem too exhausting. Certainly not looking at the style. Very fluent. Both skis over at the same time. Electing not to lunge. And then, look at this, bandstand finish. Number 37 is the one we're looking at, Alina Rajkova. She was chased all the way by the Spaniard, the only Spaniard in the field, Victoria Padial. And I think that Rajkova owes a debt to the Spaniard. Pushed her all the way. Rajkova overhauled the lead in the final lap. Remember the women, 50 kilometers, that's five laps of 3 kilometers each.
You'll be so spread your wings and fly.
Just
Education meets sport and culture. What best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.